Hello everyone, welcome back to Dragon Age Care, or Dragon Age. So my name is Tigerman, and I'm here playing from the save file, obviously. Now I know it's been a while since I played Dragon Age, and I really do apologize for that, but yeah. Well, in this episode, I don't really know what to do, so...
If there's anything I can do for you, please, please tell me.
Let me see here. So where's your story exactly?
I suppose since you told me about you being a Grey Warden, it's only fitting for me to be as open. I am originally from Orzammar, the famed dwarven city that lies beneath the stately Frostback Mountains. I was a merchant there too, merchant caste. These things are in the blood, you know. You can't just leave them behind. I ran a fairly successful business. Rare artifacts, you know. Old things, grand things. The nobles loved them. Reminded them of the lost glory days, I suppose.
Lost glory?
Our kingdoms once spanned the length of Thedas, from majestic Orzammar to Khal Sharok to glittering Darmalin far to the west. They say the gold and silver veins ran so thick through the stone of Darmalin that the entire city sparkled. The Darkspawn took it all, of course. One by one, the old Tigers fell, and then all that was left was Orzammar. But we were talking about how I ended up here, weren't we? One day, a noble woman came to my stall. She looked around for a bit and then started shrieking in dismay. Apparently, she believed that a pair of braces I had for sale once belonged to her brother. He'd been lost in a cave-in, you see, while on an expedition to clear out the Darkspawn from one of the tunnels running close to the city. They were made specially for him. They're unique, she shrieked. He stole them from my poor brother's corpse. She had me arrested on the spot, of course. Nobles, they're touchy like that. Well, I didn't steal them. You see, I'd been paying these castless thugs to venture out into the deep roads for me. The Lost Tigers, they're full of things that people left behind. Sometimes you can find a treasure, something worth a little gold.
Better do something with them, leave them rot.
That's exactly how I see it. The noble woman, she wasn't too happy with the theft of her brother's braces. I don't know what they planned for me, and I didn't want to find out. Bribed the guard that was watching me and took off for the surface first opportunity I got. Never looked back.
Huh. And now you're here.
Yes, here I am. Now, is there anything the boy or I can get you?
Let me see your wares.
I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Thank you.
Yes.
Indeed.
Indeed.
I went there, and it turns out, and it looked like there was too much going on. Let's go to the Loithery and see what's going on there. Hoping to get into a random battle so I can at least level up.
And I'm off.
Huh. Okay. So it looks like it was back. Yeah, I'm gonna switch to her.
You see them soldiers run like frightened children. Way to go!
Thank you.
Did you see the new recruiters like out?
You're here about food. Take it up with that bleeding runt by the chantry. I got other gear to sell. About food. I got other gear to sell.
Thank you.
There'll just be more bandits as soon.
You hear about food? Take it up with that bleeding runt by the chantry. I got other gear to sell.
I see you.
Check the chanter's board by the chantry. There's good jobs there. I don't suppose you know anything about poison. Well, my farm is far from town. I'm not embarrassed to say I'm nervous about Darkspawn. I've got some traps around the place. I've heard the poison hurts them beasties just as good as anybody else. I figured if I kept asking, I'd find someone. I'd pay good coin for some simple poison. Something to slow them beasties down or make them think twice. Thanks. I might have some ingredients in stock. Don't really know what you need.
Show me what you've got. That's...
Go out to the dwarves. They're safe from all these darkspawn, I bet. Living underground, that's the way to go.
They won't let you in. You'll be out of luck at their door.
Soldiers make it out of Ostagar. So much tragedy.
What are you trying to do, woman?
I was not attempting to do anything. And do not speak to me in that tone.
With the warden.
Did you desire a demonstration?
Do you believe you can control him? Did your magic fail you there?
You have no idea what you speak of, Canary.
Perhaps not, but I know of... Viper when I see one.
If you seek refuge in the Chantry, there's simply no room left. So many are coming to Lothering. I make no assumptions. Priests are within if you seek to offer devotion to the Maker, however. May he protect us all.
Goodbye.
Maker watch over you.
Maker watch over you, Bob. Thank you.
to bring that canary here. Get him out! Out!
I sense I am unwanted.
This is intolerable. Leave at once.
The canary, out of its cage.
Indeed.
I would question this, but I have far more pressing matters to deal with. Misstep, creature, and it will be your last.
A canary does not misstep.
And who are you, then?
I'm the Grey Warden.
I see. I am Ser Bryant, commander of the Lothering Templars. Tern Loghain declared all Grey Wardens traitors responsible for the king's death. You know this, I hope. I don't believe the Grey Wardens would be as careless or malicious as the Tern claims. But either way, there it is. It is best you not linger, though. Just in case.
Have you heard about any...
Other than the Darkspawn Horde bearing down on us, none of it is good. Tern Loghain is set to declare himself king, I hear. Disaster piled on disaster.
Most people are tired. Had no heir.
None that we know of. Tern Loghain has no legitimate claim on the throne. He may be a hero, and his daughter may be queen, but he is a commoner, and the king's corpse is barely cold. If Arl Eamon was able to intervene, perhaps it would not have gone this far. I do not care who takes the throne. Only fools fight over who owns a cottage while it burns down around them.
Are you in charge here?
The revered mother leads this flock. I merely command her Templars. Normally, our role is to protect the Chantry and seek out unsanctioned magic. For now, it is all we can do to protect the innocent.
Where would I find... No, I know where she is. I don't need to know that. Are you the only protection this village has?
Our ban was summoned by Tern Loghain, and he took his soldiers north with him. Lothering has been abandoned.
How do Templars fight against...
We have more than swords at our disposal. We're taught to dispel unholy magics as well. If only our powers work to keep away the Darkspawn. Alas, it is not so. In her study, no doubt, preparing what she will take when we eventually evacuate. If the matter is important, certainly. Only if you are interested in the business of mages.
I am, tell me.
I have heard word that the Templars who watch over the Circle of Magi's Tower have called for the right of annulment. Hopefully I've heard wrong.
What is the right of
annulment? If the right of annulment is invoked, the tower and every living soul within will be destroyed.
Is one of the treaties not with these mages? 'Twould be ironic to have them fricasseed just when they are useful.
To have such a call when mages are needed to fight the Darkspawn, something terrible must have happened. I have nothing else to tell you. The only news I care about is the approaching horde. Now, unless there's something else you need... They are. With the ban having taken his men north, the village is left to its fate. We will evacuate as many as we can before the horde reaches us. I will stay as long as I am needed. Now, unless there's something else you need...
Is there any other help?
I cannot openly help you, I fear, but... Here, take this key. It opens the large cabinet on the far wall. There is more there than we can carry when we evacuate, so... Take what you need.
Sweet.
Maker's breath. How many times must we drive them off? Indeed? They're gone?
It's true. I saw the bastard running for the hills myself.
That's an impressive feat indeed. Will you accept a small reward for your efforts? I wish I could afford such help, to be truthful. Take your reward, at any rate, It is all I have to offer. If it interests you, there is a Chanter's board outside full of quests that need doing. The Chanters even offer pay for some of them. Now, unless there's something else you need.
Thank you.
Travel safely, and may the Maker watch over you.
Dude, this is awesome. I didn't think you would, but I just talked to you. I also may do other stuff on my own through this and let you guys know.
The path of righteousness is full of hardship, but the Maker smiles upon its travelers.
Yes.
On behalf... You know what? Not yet. Not yet.
And I'm off.
I am led to understand that the Qunari have their own mages as well. Is this so?
You would not understand.
Not understand? Is it mental capacity that you believe I lack? Or are you worried I will sympathize with my so-called brethren?
Take your pick.
Is that supposed to make me angry?
It means I find myself wishing that your people held proper, civilized attitudes towards magic.
That is a rather hostile thing to say.
And yet you continue speaking. Astonishing.
Wow.
going.
Dropped on me there.
You know, I've got to be really honest. I really thought that was a passive, not an active passive.
What?
Blessed are the peacekeepers, champions of the just. And the stars stood still, the winds did quiet, and all animals of earth and air held their breath. All was silent in prayer and thanks.
Okay.
And I'm off.
If you must.
Because they're damned useless, that's why.
Oh, don't moan us. Just talk, that's all.
Greetings, my lord.
Enough! I'll not have my kitchen invaded by ramblers tracking mud in on their shoes.
Allow me. I could do that for you. On my way.
Why don't they mages just whip up a spell and make those darkspawn go away?
Because they're damned useless, that's why.
They say your mother is Flemeth, a witch of the Kokari Wilds.
They also say that washing your feet in winter makes you catch cold in the head, but we all know that is not true. But sometimes they are right. And they are right in this.
You know the stories about...
Of course. You think my mother would let me go without telling me all the stories of her youth?
My mother told me stories too. She was the one who kindled my love of the old tales and legends.
My mother's stories curdled my blood and haunted my dreams. No little girl wants to hear about the wilder men her mother took to her bed, using them till they were spent, then killing them. No little girl wants to be told that this is also expected of her once she comes of age.
I see.
No, you don't. You really don't.
Do you have coins, stranger? With Orzammar closed off, old Tegrin can give you a discount. Fine weapon and arms, dwarven made. There's two things I'm here for. Travel or trade. Understand?
Stop right there, outsider. The Dalish have camped in this spot. I suggest you go elsewhere, and quickly. And now you do. It makes no difference, however, for you are unwelcome in our camp. Good. I suggest you avoid this area in the future, at least until we leave.
Circle of Magi are, or I can't remember.
I thought I saw travelers coming down the road, though I scarcely believed it. Have you come to help us? So you don't know? Has nobody out there heard? He could be dead for all we know. Nobody's heard from the castle in days.
We're under attack. Monsters come out of the castle every night and attack us until dawn. Everyone's been fighting and dying.
Apparently everyone seems to agree that a blight is the perfect time to start killing each other. Marvelous, really.
We've no army to defend us. No Arl and no king to send us help. So many are dead. And those left are terrified they're next. I should take you to Ban Tegan. He's all that's holding us together. He'll want to see you. He's just over there in the chantry. Please, come.
Okay, this is gonna be really stupid for me to say, but I kinda thought the chantry was just over there in the loitering.
It's Thomas, yes? And who are these people with you? They're obviously not simple travelers.
No, my lord. They just arrived, and I thought you would want to see them.
Well done, Thomas. Greetings, friends. My name is Tegan, Ban of Rainosphere, brother to the Arl. You're a rather unusual group, to say the least. Can I ask who you are and why you've come? A Grey Warden? I thought you all died along with my nephew. At least that is what Loghain would have us believe.
Do you believe?
I refer to Caelan, of course. Our sister was Queen Rowan, King Merrick's wife and Caelan's mother, make her rest her soul.
There is a Grey Warden who goes by the name of Alistair. Does he yet live? My brother raised him. If Alistair's alive, I'm certain he will want to know. He does? Finally, some good news amidst all the bad. Thank you. You're here to see my brother. Unfortunately, that might be a problem. Eamon is gravely ill. No one has heard from the castle in days. No guards patrol the walls, and no one has responded to my shouts. The attack started a few nights ago. Evil things surged from the castle. We drove them back, but many perished during the assault.
What evil things are we...
Some call them the walking dead, decomposing corpses, returning to life with a hunger for human flesh. They hit again the next night. Each night they come with greater numbers. With Caelan dead and Loghain starting a war over the throne, no one responds to my urgent calls for help. I have a feeling tonight's assault will be the worst yet. I'm asking you, please, help us. Help Eamon.
First, I have
by
questions.
All means.
I
tried. Our one attempt at an organized evacuation resulted in an immediate attack. Yesterday, I found out these creatures attack those fleeing on their own, even during daytime. Whatever lies in the castle wants this village dead.
Isn't there a way to enter the castle?
The castle is closed to us, its doors barred. We could storm it, certainly, but what would that accomplish? Our numbers are too few. We cannot throw men at the castle walls when they are needed to protect the village.
What happens after tonight?
Once the village is safe, we will try to enter the castle to find the source of this trouble.
I've heard enough.
Then you will help us?
Yeah, I will.
There are no darkspawn here, and nothing to gain. It is a fool's errand.
What would you have us do instead?
Leave. The plan was never to come and defend this village. Yet helping these humans does nothing of the sort.
How pointless to help these villagers fight an impossible battle. One would think we had enough to contend with elsewhere.
Thank you. Thank you. This means more to me than you can guess. Thomas, please tell Murdoch what transpired. Then return to your post.
Yes, my lord.
Now then, there is much to do before night falls. I put two men in charge of the defense outside. Murdoch, the village mayor, is outside the chantry. Sir Perth, one of Eamon's knights, is just up the cliff at the windmill, watching the castle. You may discuss with them the preparations for the coming battle.
I want to discuss.
Of course.
You have some of our knights now?
I have those few who returned from their quest. You know of this, yes?
Search for a sacred
action. Yes, I question Isolde's decision to send so many knights in search of this relic. But I am a practical man, whereas she is a woman of great faith. Sir Perth was one of the knights sent on this quest. Perhaps you should speak to him if you wish to learn more.
Why are you in the chantry?
Sir Perth insists. He wants me to be with the villagers, so everyone he needs to protect is in one place. I don't mind, to be honest. The point of all this is to protect the villagers, and I can do that best here. This is the last line of defense, should things go amiss.
Won't that look cowardly?
I'm not here for glory. I would prefer being outside, but Perth has a point. We could bring some men in to stand beside me.
But I'd rather keep the monsters away from the villagers if possible.
So why are these things attacking the village?
I do not know. They seem to be walking corpses, men with rotting flesh that continue to attack even with the gravest injuries.
Undead, spirits possessing the dead. There could be several causes behind such a thing, none of them pleasant.
So what happens after this battle?
Hopefully we can find the source and stop it before it causes any more damage. With luck, we'll also find Eamon and be able to help him. Very well. Luck be with you, my friend.
I'm scared, Mother. When are the bad men coming?
Soon, darling. Don't worry. Everything will be all right.
But I won't...
Why has the king not come? Surely soldiers could have marched here by now. Where are they all? What are they doing?
Alright, guys, you know what? I'm gonna save right here. And in all seriousness, go ahead and tell me in the comments below, like, what should I do? Blah, blah, blah. Thank you all so much for watching. I will see you all in the next episode. Bye-bye.